Assalamu alaikum, my dear students. Now let's start the lecture of information technology for standard 12th. Chapter number 3, advanced JavaScript. Now today we are going to solve the skill oriented practical number 1, that is SOP 1, where the question is divided into two parts. That means you need to create two web pages. In first web page, it is written that create a web page in HTML having a white background and two button objects. That means you need to create a form having two button objects and white background. Okay, write code using JavaScript such that when the mouse is placed over, you need to write down the event, you need to call an event on mouse over. Okay, on when the mouse is placed over on the button, then you need to call the function. Okay, and the color of the background of the page should change after every dash second. That means automatically the color of the background should change after every n milliseconds. So you are supposed to decide the time where 1000 milliseconds is equal to 1 second. I already explained you that in previous lectures, that 1000 milliseconds is equal to 1 millisecond 1 second. So there should be at least 7 distinct, different and visibly distinct background colors, excluding the default color. You need to exclude the default color and you need to change the 7 different background colors. When the second button object is clicked, now when the second object is clicked, appropriate measure should be displayed on the web browser's status bar. That means you need to create two buttons. On first button, when you move the mouse pointer, it will start changing the color, background color, into 7 colors. And when the second button is clicked, then it should display the status on the status bar. This is the first section where you need to create a web page. In second section, you need to create another web page using JavaScript where the background color changes automatically every after dash seconds. Now here automatically word is used, that means when the page is loaded, at that time you need to start changing the background color of the page. This event must be triggered automatically after the page gets loaded in the web browser. Correct? There should be at least 7 distinct, different, visibly distinct background color when the page is unloaded. Now when the page gets open, at that time you need to start changing the color, and when the page gets closed, then the appropriate alert message should be displayed. Now you need to display an alert message on closing of the window. Got it? So this is the question. Now we will start with the programming part. This is our program. Okay, where you are supposed to create a form first, correct? So starting with HTML, head, title, head, close, body. After body, you need to create a form where you need to create two buttons. On first button, on mouse over event, you need to call a function fun1 where the background color starts changing into 7 different colors. Okay, and on clicking on the second button, you need to display a function. So I'm calling a function here to display the status on the status bar. Got it? Now see function fun1. This is the first function which I am calling on mouse over event, right? So this is the first event on mouse over where I am calling a function fun1. That means when you move your mouse pointer on the button and when you are on the button, okay, when you are on the button, then it starts changing the color. But before moving out of the button, it starts changing the color. Got it? So here we are going to write the function fun1. In this function fun1, what we need to do, we need to first start changing the color. So document.bgColor is equal to red. First, it will change the background color into red, and then it will use the set timeout. Now we are using set timeout function. Okay, this set timeout method what this set timeout method will do, it will call another function after few milliseconds. So after 1000 milliseconds, I'm going to call a function fun2. So it first come inside the function 1, it will change the background color to red, and then it will call another function fun2 after 1000 milliseconds. After changing the background color into red, it will call the second function, that is fun2 function. Okay, so by using window.setTimeout, see, this is the method window.setTimeout. SetTimeout is a method of window object which will start changing the background color after every 1000 milliseconds. That means first time when user move the mouse pointer on the button, then it will call function 1. In function 1, you're going to change the color to red, and after changing the color to red, after 1000 milliseconds of changing the color into red, you're going to call another function, that is fun2. Okay, in this fun2 function, now you are calling a function, so you need to declare a function too. So to declare a function, we use function keyword and then fun2. This is the second function which I am creating. Now document.bgColor is equal to blue. Now after calling this second function, after 1000 milliseconds, it will change the background color to blue. Okay, and it will again call the function 3 after 1000 seconds of blue, changing the background color to blue. So window.setTimeout fun3, it will call the function 3 after 1000 milliseconds. That means after 1 minute, after 1 second, it will call function 3. Got it? So first it will come inside, it will change the color to red, it will call the function 1 2 after 1000 milliseconds. Then in fun2, it will change the background color to blue, and after changing the background color to blue, it will call the function 3, where I am going to change the background color to red. Okay, after changing color to red, it will call another function after 1000 milliseconds, which is function 4. In function 4, I am changing the background color to yellow. Okay, this is the fourth color, yellow. And after changing the background color to yellow, after 1000 milliseconds of changing the background color to yellow, I am calling a function fun5. This is the fifth function which I am calling. So in function 5, what I am doing, I am changing the background color to cyan color. Okay, after 1000 milliseconds of changing the color to cyan, I am going to call a function fun6 here. So it will call a function fun6 after 1000 seconds of, after 1000 milliseconds of changing the color to cyan. So in function 6, what I am doing, in function 6, I am changing the background color to gold color, and I am calling function 7 here after 1000 milliseconds of changing the color to gold. Then in function 7, I am again changing the background color to silver. Seven colors are completed. Now what I need to do, after seven colors, it will automatically change the background color to the first color, that is red color, right? Then red, blue, green, yellow, like this. Then again it will change the background color starting from red. So this cycle will continue when you write or when you call fun1 at the end, that is in function 7, after 1000 milliseconds. Got it? So to create a cycle, we will call fun1 in fun7 to continue changing the background color till the window is closed. Now see this first part. See the first part of this. Now see, when I move my mouse pointer, see, I am not clicking anywhere, I am just moving my mouse pointer on this button. So on mouse over, when the mouse pointer is over on the button, the background color starts changing into 7 color. Correct? See, now again it starts from red. After 7th color, it will again starts from red. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now again red. Correct? So this cycle will continue till you close this window. Okay? Now, what is the second part of this question? The second part of this question is you need to display the status on the status bar after clicking on the second button object. So where is the second button object? Now see in the program. See students, second button object. On second button object, we are calling an event, that is on click event, where I am going to call a function fun status. This is my function which will help us to change the status on the status bar. Okay, now see, where's the function? Here. Now I am creating a function fun status where window.status. Now what we are doing, we are setting the status on the status bar. So window.status is equal to hello. Okay, so this status will set on the status bar of the window. Now it support only in Internet Explorer 6.0. Only Internet Explorer 6.0 is supporting this feature of window object. In other web browser, this feature is not supported by other web browsers like Google Chrome, Internet Explorer new version, or in Opera, etc. Okay? These web browsers are not supporting this feature of window object, that is window.status. So if you're executing it Google Chrome or Internet Explorer new version, it will not display the status on the status bar. Okay, so there is no error in this, but the browser is not supporting that feature. Got it? Now we will see the second part, another part of the program, that is to create the another web page using JavaScript. Now we are going to create the another web page using JavaScript where the background color changes automatically after every dash seconds. Now here you don't need to create any button object, you just need to open the window, and as soon as the window gets open, it starts changing the color. It should start changing the color, right? So the difference is only at the body tag. Okay, save as. We will save this program as SOP1 p2.html. Okay, now see, the changes will be only here in form tag. Instead of form, you don't need to create any form tag. Okay, what you need to do, you need to write an event, onload event. Okay, onload event is the attribute of body tag. So you need to use this onload event on body. That means when the page gets loaded, that means when the body content gets loaded on the web browser, that time you need to change the color, right? So the function fun1 is going to call here. We are going to call the function fun1 here in this onload, on this onload event. Okay, so body onload is equal to fun1. This fun1 is my function name which is going to call as soon as the body gets loaded on the web browser. Got it? Then after that, so here when the page gets loaded, at that time the function fun1 is going to call. Okay, and in previous program we were calling the function on clicking on the object or on mouse move event of the object. Correct? So the difference is only here that the form is replaced with the onload event of the body tag. Got it? So you don't need to create the form tag, you just need to write down the body onload is equal to fun1. Okay, then second part is this event must be triggered automatically after the page gets loaded in the browser. There should be at least be 7 different and visibly distinct background color. Again, you need to change the 7 background colors excluding the white color. Okay, when the page is unloaded, now when the page is unloaded means when the page is closed. Okay, the appropriate alert message should be displayed. That means when you close the web page, at that time on unload event is occur. Okay, so on unload is equal to, I am going to call another function, that is fun. Fun message. This is my another function which is going to call when the page gets unloaded on the web browser. So I am going to make the changes here also. Fun MSG. And here you need to display the alert message. So alert, what you need to display? You need to display a message by message on the screen. Okay, you can display any message here. Got it? I am displaying by message when the page gets unloaded. Now we will execute this program. See, this is the second program. Okay, now see what will happen when I allow block contain. It will automatically start changing the background color. I have not clicked anywhere, I have not moved the mouse pointer. It starts changing the background color automatically as soon as the page gets loaded or the page gets opened on the web browser. Okay, now second one is when I close the window. So after closing the window, it should display a message. See, this is the message. One second. Open Internet Explorer. Allow block contained. Now when I close this window, open another one. When I close this window, it should display a message on the screen. So this way you can display the message on the screen on unloading of the window, and on loading of the window you can display the you can change the background colors into 7 colors. All the programs will be the same, only the changes is in body you are supposed to use on load event. That's it. Okay, now I hope you have understood these two programs. These two programs will come in your exam or in a practical exam for 9 marks. Okay, so we'll stop here. In next lecture we'll see or we will solve another SOP question of this chapter, that is SOP 2, where you need to check the palindrome value. Okay. Thank you so much.